हेलो जाह्नवी लहरी, वेरी गुड इवनिंग जाह्नवी। आई एम जस्ट वेटिंग फॉर सम मोर पीपल टू कम। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू पीपल? जाह्नवी एंड लहरी, एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू? ओके, या वेरी गुड इवनिंग। सो आई विल बी डीलिंग विथ the topic called as thermal expansion of solids. This topic will be related to heat. As I need not explain you, this is related to heat. So shall we start? Lahari and Jahanavi, you can even unmute and you can speak also. Okay, Jahanavi. You can unmute and you can ask your doubts also. Not at all a problem. So first, let us start with the discussion. We are discussing about the thermal expansion of solids. So here you already know that there are certain kind of substances or some substances in nature which expand on heating. I am saying only some substances. Why? Because not all kind of substances doesn't expand on heating. There are certain substances which contract on heating also. So that's why I'm giving you the first point as there are some substances which expand on heating. So if you provide heat energy, the object, the substance temperature increases, the substance temperature rises, and it undergoes expansion. That is the basic point. Next, the second point is solids are going to expand lengthwise and as well as area wise. Next, volume wise means what? What is the meaning? Solids expand lengthwise, area and volume wise means what? Linear expansion means lengthwise the solids expansion is taken, considered, and the solids expand area wise, and they even expand volume wise also. So volume increases as we heat, as the temperature rises to sufficient amount, the volume of the substance increases, area of the substance increases, and sometimes length of the substance increases. So we call them as linear expansion. If there is a lengthwise expansion, we call it as linear expansion. If there is a expansion of the substance body by area, then it is areal expansion, and this areal expansion we even call it as superficial expansion. Superficial expansion, this is length expansion or linear expansion. And next, volume is expansion. It is, if volume increases, that's a volume expansion. This is also by heating. Next, coming to liquids and gases, they expand only volume wise. That you know very well, all of you. It's a very basic thing. That is, liquids, we measure the quantity of liquid with the help of volume. Length of liquid, area of liquid, we usually don't take. And gas also, its volume of the gas we measure, pressure of the gas, volume of the gas, temperature of the gas. These are the thermodynamic properties of a gas. So therefore liquid expansion volume wise we take. Next up, gas expansion. If a gas or a gaseous substance is filled in a container like thing, and if it is heated, if the container is heated, then gas inside the container gets heated up and it undergoes, it tries to expand. The expansion we measure in terms of volume, that is volume wise expansion. Next up, now in relation with this topic, I need to explain you about the type of objects in terms of expansion. Means isotropic objects, isotropic bodies and anisotropic bodies, these two objects, they expand differently, or their property slightly it is different. Why? Because isotropic bodies and anisotropic bodies, they react to heat energy, they react to rise in temperature differently. What is that difference? Let us see. Isotropic bodies are having same properties in all directions. Means what? Same properties in all directions, and hence the expansion is same in all directions. Means what? Exactly, what is the meaning? So it means so here, suppose I am considering a solid body. You can see here, Jahnavi and others, Lahari, all of you. Suppose this is a solid body and its directions are like this. These are the directions. Means I have three directions here, you can see. These are the three different directions. What are they? Isotropic objects, they have same properties in all directions, and hence the expansion is same in all directions. Directions means what? Say the expansion of this body in x direction, the expansion of the object in y direction, the expansion of the object along z direction. The expansion considered differently along a particular direction. Suppose this cube, you take the length of the cube, breadth and height, three dimensions you take. Then lengthwise expansion and breadthwise expansion and heightwise expansion, so they are same, it is said. So the properties are same. Means this particular crystal, this particular solid object, its expansion is same in x direction, in y and z direction, in all the three directions. Similarly, all isotropic bodies, their expansion will be homogeneous, same in all the directions. And these are the examples. Next, anisotropic bodies means their expansions will be different. So majority or most of the crystalline solid materials, they expand anisotropically, and only few objects undergo isotropic expansion, that is metals and some solids like glass and some separate category of crystals, they undergo expansion equally in all the directions, which comes under isotropic expansion. And anisotropic bodies means they don't expand in the same way in all directions. So Jahnavi, you tell me, so far you have understood or not? Do you need any clarification? So far are we clear? Lahari, you also, you can speak, you can unmute and you can talk to me, you can ask your doubts if at all anything is there, and any kind of clarification, please don't worry about anything. You can happily ask, you can clarify, you can plenty of concepts and problems you can learn here. And I can promise you that there won't be not understanding such kind of thing, there won't be anything, that I can promise you. And I can take the responsibility of your understanding, your score, your marks, anything. So I am here to support you in all ways, nothing to worry. And I'll make you, within few days, I'll make you this particular subject, I'll make you easy. If you feel difficult, if you have any phobia, definitely you will be getting rid of all those phobias. And I can make you the physics subject so easy, so flexible and comfortable, that responsibility I am here to take you. Don't worry about it. But only what you have to do is just simply lot of questioning you ask, you solve, and if I give any problem, without hesitation try, and if you don't get, I'll be explaining you. Don't worry about it. So is it okay? Whatever I said, Jahnavi, is it okay? Lahari?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
good,
sir.
Good. Very good, ma. Good. Superb. Thank you for responding. Thank you so much. So I hope this is clear, I think. These points. Now let us proceed to the next aspect. So now, if temperature of a substance rises, then what happens? My question is, first of all, why these solids expand? What is the reason? Why does the solid basically expand? What happens inside the solid? That is my question. I will tell you, but before that you think. Suppose I have a solid material and the solid atoms I am taking, for example, suppose these are the solid atoms, they have a constant interatomic separation, means the separation will be there, same, this interatomic separation will be there. I am just assuming the solid particles separation to be same, the interatomic separation I am taking. Now, like this, many layers are there in a solid, lot of particles are there inside the solid. As you know very well, the difference between solids and liquids, you know anyway, what solid substance, in that the particles or the atoms will be tightly, closely packed and they have a definite shape and structure, whereas liquids are, the particles of the liquids are very much free, and in gases more than that it is free. Absolutely, the particles are going to be free, the spacing is too large and they are not tightly packed. This all you know already. This is a very basic thing. Now, what I am going to say is, these are the particles I am taking for a solid, and assuming that to this solid material or solid system, this is the bonding and many particles are there, below and above many particles are there, but I am providing some heat energy. And due to which its temperature is increased, its temperature is raised. So I am just giving some heat energy and its temperature keeps on rising, it is going to increase. And after some time, assuming that the particles have absorbed enough amount of heat energy, then what is going to happen inside? That's my question. You just think, try. Means, frankly, you just give your opinion, that's it. It may be right or wrong, I don't mind. No issues. But if you don't give the answer, then only I'll feel bad about it. If you interact, I'll be happy. Janavitil.
Sir, I have checked that the solid particles are present very closely.
Mm.
Whenever the temperature is increasing and we are going at, they may expand.
Yeah, that's true. So, expansion means what is happening inside? That is my question. Up to here, whatever you said, it's correct. Further, what next that I am asking means, why do they expand? Heat energy is given to the solids. Yeah, Vaishnavi, we just started with this, with the topic. Just now we had some conversation regarding the thermal expansions. That is the update, Vaishnavi. Jahanavi, 1 second. Vaishnavi, just see here, we just started with this, ma. Thermal expansion of solids, we just started. I was discussing the basic aspects of thermal expansion. That's the update. So, just go through this. And Jahanavi and Vaishnavi, Lahari, you also, if you want, you can, if you don't want, it's okay. If you want, you can take a screenshot, just within a fraction of time. You can just have a screenshot of it if you need some information, or else just leave it. I'll just give you a minute. If you want, you can just take a screenshot. Vaishnavi, you can unmute and you can talk to me. You can ask some doubts. You can ask about the topic also. Nothing to worry. Happily, you people can clarify your doubts. You can ask a lot of questions. We can have, we are going to have a wonderful interaction. Don't worry about it. Okay, na? Shall we proceed further?
Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir.
Vaishnavi, what about you? Do you need any explanation? You can unmute and you can talk. So, we just discussed about the thermal expansion of solids. These are the basic things. Next. So here, I was explaining about why a solid expands. That was my explanation. I just started about that. Suppose I'm just considering some solid particles. Just only few particles I'm considering. That doesn't mean that only four atoms are there. That is not the meaning. Many, a solid material has number of particles inside which are tightly, closely packed, and they have a regular systematic arrangement that you know. And liquids are loosely packed, and gaseous particles are more free than the liquid materials, liquid particles. So now what we are considering here is many particles are there in this way, in this array, and in this way, lengthwise, breadthwise, heightwise, group of particles, number of particles are there in a solid. That is my assumption. Now my question was, Vaishnavi, just listen. What I was telling is, I posed a question to these people, that is, to this solid material, some amount of heat energy I have provided. Then we have observed some rise of temperature. So almost you people were over there. The heat is absorbed by the solid material and there was some rise in temperature. I keep on giving some heat energy, the temperature will be rising. Then this heat energy, how does it affect the solid particles inside? Why does it lead to expansion? How does the particles help in expansion? What is going to happen inside? That's my question. Exactly, we are about to discuss about what is exactly going to happen inside. How does it expand? That's one discussion.
So can I see, sir?
What, ma?
Can I see, sir?
I didn't get you.
Can I answer the question, sir?
Ah, you can answer happily. Anytime, just you can unmute and you can ask me. Happily you can ask.
As we are supplying the heat, the particles get to vibrate, sir.
Wow, superb.
And due to that vibration, the kinetic energy may arise, and so that the expansion goes on, I think so.
Super. Very good, ma. Wonderful. Excellent. I just need this. This kind of answering I want. If you know, if even if it is wrong also, I'll appreciate you. You happily need not worry about right or wrong. You just bother about, you have to answer, that's it. If, whether it is a correct answer or wrong answer, nothing, it is not at all an issue for me. Just you have to answer, that's it. If you keep on interacting, you will be more into the subject and you can understand, we can go for a lot of applications, a lot of problems we can solve. Yep. Purnima, we are just discussing the thermal expansions, Purnima. So now, Lahari, you also, Janavi. So let me complete your statement. Some heat energy is provided to the solid particles. So these solid particles are going to vibrate. They are going to oscillate. They are going to oscillate. Why means they absorb heat energy. We have provided heat energy, and that heat energy is absorbed by the solid particles and they undergo oscillation, they undergo vibration. Okay. Those vibrations are called as हार्मोनिक वाइब्रेशंस, नथिंग बट वन विच वी डिस्कस इन SHM और ऑसिलेशन चैप्टर. सो दिस पार्टिकल्स अब्सॉर्ब हीट एनर्जी एंड दे अंडरगो ऑसिलेशन, दे अंडरगो हार्मोनिक वाइब्रेशंस. दिस इज एट सम मॉडरेट टेम्परेचर्स. नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज आई विल प्रोवाइड मोर हीट एनर्जी. सो प्रेजेंटली सम हीट एनर्जी आई एम प्रोवाइडिंग विथ विच particles absorb heat energy, they undergo vibration which are named as harmonic vibration. Next, some more heat energy I am going to add further, and the temperature rise finally is say some delta T dash. Finally, this is more vigorously the particles are going to oscillate more vigorously. So what means the next thing which is going to happen is unharmonic vibrations are going to take place, unharmonic vibration. So harmonicity will get disturbed, and the vigorous vibration of the particles lead to an unharmonic vibration, which is because of the further increase of heat energy, further rise of temperature, and this unharmonic vibration will lead to thermal expansion. It will give the thermal expansion. Why? Means as the particles expand vigorously, particles, atoms won't expand actually. Atoms won't expand. The interatomic separation, it will increase. The interatomic separation between particle to particle, this is going to increase. Means initially let it be say some R naught, interatomic separation, particle to particle. From R naught, it will increase slightly. R naught to R naught plus delta R means slightly the delta R is the increase. Slightly it will increase. Slightly this will increase. Slightly this will increase. Slightly. Particle to particle separation increases, means not in meters, not in centimeters, in micrometers, nanometers, very small, we can't even see that much small expansion between 1 and 2, between 2 and 3, between 3 and 4, between 4 and 5, like that. These particles, their interatomic separation increases, and that will give you some expansion of 1 mm or half mm or something like that. A small expansion is going to happen if the interatomic separation increases vigorously. But why the interatomic separation, why it has increased? It is a solid, it is tightly packed, it can't change. Actually these distances can't be increased, but we have provided huge amount of energy, large amount of heat energy, and temperature has raised enormously. We have increased the temperature. So what is going to happen? The interatomic separation, slightly it increases between 1 and 2, 2 and 3, 3 and 4, so on, between each and every any two consecutive particles, the separation has increased. This leads to this initially with moderate temperature rise, with moderate heat energy, harmonic vibrations, particle used to vibrate harmonically. If you increase the amount of heat energy, the vibrations changed to unharmonic vibrations. Unharmonic means it is a disturbed, irregular vibration. Vigorous vibrations, which leads to the interatomic separation, increase of interatomic separation, and that will give you the linear expansion or areal expansion, anything, volume expansion. If this interatomic separation increases lengthwise, then that rod or that wire will undergo linear expansion. If this interatomic separation increases in x direction, in y direction, here also one particle you take, here also one particle you take, in this direction expansion takes place, in this direction expansion takes place, then area will expand. Suppose in this direction also it will expand, then volume expansion. So what do you say, Janavi? Lahari, what about you? Got it?
Thank you. Clear, sir.
Good, good. Very good.
Understood, sir.
Okay, ma. Good. Next up. Now, so this is the point related to our explanation. That is, as the temperature rises, the average distance of separation increases because of its anharmonic vibration of atoms. On the whole, as a gross effect, as a total effect, matter expands with equal proportions in all directions. The expansion is same in all directions if it is for an isotropic solid. Next, now these are few equations related to which we are going to solve problems. So the first one is coefficient of linear expansion. So coefficient of linear expansion means, first, if I consider a solid object, say a thin rod, and heat energy will be provided, then this rod has initially a length L naught or L something, unexpanded length means before expansion, and as it expands slightly, let the expansion be delta L. This length expansion delta L is proportional to its original length, and it is directly proportional to rise in temperature. More the rise in temperature, more will be its length expansion delta L. More will be its original length, more the scope of expansion. So if you remove this, delta L is L alpha delta T. So this is the expression that is written here, delta L equals to L alpha delta T. Next, from this alpha, if you calculate, it will be linear expansion coefficient. This alpha, it is called as coefficient of linear expansion. Coefficient of linear expansion. So this is alpha, and it is measured in either degree Celsius inverse or Kelvin inverse. Degree Celsius inverse or Kelvin inverse, or 1 by degree Celsius, 1 by Kelvin is the SI unit, 1 by Kelvin, it is the SI unit. Next, these are the expressions we are going to use for problem solving, basic, easy. So delta L is expansion length, which is L alpha delta T, and alpha is delta L by L delta T, where this L is the length expansion, the original length before expansion, delta T is the rise of temperature. Next, this is one more expression which gives you the final length, initial length before expansion, final length after expansion. L2, I am taking it as the final length, L1 as the original length. So L2 equals to L1 of 1 plus alpha delta T. So here, suppose delta L equals to, we have taken L alpha delta T. So here delta L means final length minus initial length is the change in length or increase in length, equals to original length L1 into alpha delta T, from which L2 equals to this L1 plus L1 alpha delta T, like this. In this way we have the expression. This is the expression L2 equal to L1 of 1 plus alpha delta T. Similarly, I am not going to tell you all these things, the same as it is. For linear expansion, whatever expressions we have, same, we just change with area. Length is replaced with area. Alpha, linear expansion coefficient, coefficient of linear expansion is alpha. Next, here beta, coefficient of aerial expansion is beta. Next, coefficient of volume expansion is gamma. So gamma is here. So this is gamma. Delta A, change in area, or increase in area, increase in volume, increase in length. Alpha, beta, gamma, linear, aerial, and volume expansion coefficient. And this is these are the coefficients, alpha, beta, gamma. And final length after expansion, final area after expansion, final volume after expansion. So these are the basic expressions for thermal expansion. So shall we proceed further? I hope up to here it is clear, I hope. Janavi, what about you?
Understood, sir.
Okay, so we'll solve some problems. Lahari, okay?
Yes, clear, sir.
Okay, fine. And one more thing is, this length expansion relation . This is the length expansion, L final equals to L initial of 1 plus alpha delta T. This expression, you can extend it to radius R equals to R naught of 1 plus alpha delta T. You can use it for radius, you can use it for diameter, D equals to D naught of 1 plus alpha delta T. Means what? Suppose you have a ring or a disc or any kind of material, where its radius is a criteria of measurement. We are measuring the radius of the ring, a metal ring, or a disc metal, a metallic disc, something like that, or a solid sphere, whatever. Then radius initial, radius final, before expansion, after expansion, if you take, then the initial and final radius, you can relate it like this. Why we are taking like that? So radius is a linear quantity, it's a linear dimension. So the linear expansion can be applied, and the diameter is also, it's a linear dimension. If it is area, then it is two dimensional. Volume is having three different dimensions. So this is one point. Next, now we'll take up a question. So here, I have a, this is a ring, it is a metal ring, this has got some radius, and the radius is smaller, and this expansion coefficient, the linear expansion coefficient of the ring is given by alpha metal, alpha m. This is the given information. Next, there is a cylindrical material. This is a cylindrical material, and this cylindrical material, its radius is capital R, where capital R is greater than small r. Means what? This cylindrical material is slightly more, its radius I am considering numerically more, and this cylindrical material is a wooden cylinder. I am choosing this as a wooden cylinder so that it doesn't expand. So now the question is, to what temperature, the metal ring, has to be raised? To what temperature metal ring has to be raised so that it exactly, fits into the wooden cylinder? So what is the question? You can see here, to what temperature this ring has to be heated. Actually, this metal ring is having a small radius, less radius than the radius of the cylinder, wooden cylinder. Its radius is more, it is less. Of course, you may ask, sir, diagram wise this is big, na? Okay, you just don't consider that. What do you say, Lahari, Janavi? Diagrammatically, sir, this smaller, this is seems to be big, means, okay, I have drawn like that. So, but I am mentioning the condition. The wooden cylinder, it has small, more radius, that's what I am considering. And a ring has less. If you want, I can redraw again, if you ask.
No need, sir. It is understandable.
No need.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay. So, now the question is, you try to understand. This, even if you heat this wooden cylinder, assume that its expansion is negligible. Just assume that this cylindrical material is not going to expand, and I am going to heat this so that after expansion this metal ring has to fit into the wooden cylinder. That is a condition. So for which, to what temperature it has to be raised? So tell me the idea. Either you can solve and give me the answer, or you can give your idea. In any of the ways it's okay. So how to solve? Jahnavi, your idea? How to proceed?
Sorry, sir, I have no idea about this.
Okay, I'll explain you. Lahari, what about you? So I'm telling, just listen. So here the ring radius is, the initial radius of the ring is smaller. It has to fit exact, this ring has to fit exactly into the onto the cylinder. The ring has to exactly fit onto the cylinder. So its final radius should be, the ring's final radius should be capital R. Is it okay? See and tell. This is my first step. Initial radius is this much. Sorry, this one. Ring initial radius. And after expansion, I gave some heat energy, some temperature is raised, which I don't know. So final radius is capital R. Up to here, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
So this is clear now. Why? Because if this has to fit into this, onto the cylindrical material, if that ring has to fit, this is the requirement. Final radius this much. Now I'll use the relation. Final radius equals to initial radius of 1 plus alpha metal into delta t. So what am I going to substitute here? Final radius is I need exactly capital R, and here initial radius small r of 1 plus alpha metal into delta t I have to find out. That's all. From this you have to solve and calculate the rise in temperature. To what temperature it has to be raised, that delta t you have to calculate from this. That's all. So I think now you can give the answer, I think.
So cap delta t is equals to capital R by smaller into 1 plus
One
alpha
second.
m.
The next step is like this actually. R I'll multiply inside plus R alpha delta t. So this will be R capital R minus small r is equals to R alpha delta t. This is visible now, this last step. Up to here, this is visible now. I can write up to here now.
Yes, sir.
Then final step, delta t from this, how much I will be getting? See, just see, check the calculation. Is it okay? Okay, see this. Delta t r minus r by r alpha. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, na. So this is the temperature rise up to which I have to heat the ring so that it exactly fits into the wooden cylinder. Completed, huh?
Yes,
Good.
sir.
Good, very good. So we'll proceed to the next question. So the question is, two rods A and B are having lengths L1, L2, and expansion coefficients, linear expansion coefficients alpha 1, alpha 2. Then these two rods A and B are combined to form a composite rod. To form a composite rod. Composite means a single rod. After joining, they both act as a single rod. We have joined them, both the two rods we have joined. But the thing is, these two objects, they are having different expansion coefficients, different lengths. That is the point. Means what? Different expansion coefficients means what? If you provide same amount of heat energy to the two rods combination, each of them will expand differently since their expansion coefficients are different. So the question is, what you have to find out here is, find the effective linear expansion, find the effective linear expansion coefficient. But you might have heard this effective or resultant, that word, in electricity, two resistors are connected, and what we calculate usually, effective resistance we calculate or not? You just recollect that.
And yes, sir.
Parallel, yes or no? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So there we find R effective, na? That R effective is R1 plus R2, or 1 by R effective is 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 for parallel. But here, those formulae we won't be using here, but I am just recollecting you what is the effective value. So in electrical resistances, we usually calculate the effective value. So here in this rod, the effective alpha value I want, means rod 1 having a expansion coefficient alpha 1, second one alpha 2. When they combine to form a single rod, a composite rod, its alpha effective we have to calculate. So shall we calculate? Shall I? Can I proceed?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let us find out. First, suppose I am providing commonly same amount of heat energy to both of them. I am providing same amount of heat energy to rod 1 and rod 2. Then this delta Q is the provided heat energy to composite rod, means combination. Then they expand differently. So what I can see is total or net expansion of this combined composite rod is equals to, I can say, expansion of first rod plus expansion of second rod, the linear expansion of yes or no? Delta L1 plus delta L2, we can write it like this, huh?
Yes, sir.
Dhanavi? Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
So, okay. So, now I am going to write it like delta L net, this I am going to write it like this. Net length, total length is L1 plus L2 into alpha effective into delta T equals to delta L1, I am writing it as L1 alpha 1 delta T, plus delta L2, I am writing it as L2 alpha 2 delta T. Delta L1, so is this step clear, all of you? Delta L net, delta L is L alpha delta T, delta L1, L alpha delta T, L alpha delta T. This is expansion of only first one, expansion of only second, expansion of the combination. Combination means, if I imagine this as a single rod, if I imagine this as a single rod having a length L1 plus L2, having expansion coefficient alpha effective, this is my imagination, this is my assumption, that this is replaced with one single rod of length L1 plus L2, coefficient alpha effective. So this one, this. So for this, this is the net expansion. Delta L net for this is L1 plus L2 into alpha effective into delta T. Temperature change is same. I have given heat energy same to both the rods. So now I think you can calculate the alpha effective, I think. Lahari, what do you say? Now you people can calculate or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now delta T same only for both of them. Means for both the rods I gave same heat energy, same rise in temperature. That is a condition, and this delta T you can cancel out happily on both sides, and you can, what are you supposed to find finally? Alpha effective you have to find out. Tell me. So calculating na? You people are calculating, no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Good. So if you have done your calculation, you can give the answer. Just finish the calculation and give me the alpha effective value correctly. Yeah.
L1 alpha 1 plus L2 alpha 2 by L1 plus L2, sir.
Okay. Okay, done. Same, huh?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, similar, na? Okay. So, effective coefficient, we got it. So, it's clear, no? So, shall we proceed to the next question?
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Yeah. The question is, two rods A and B of expansion coefficients alpha 1 and alpha 2. And the main condition given in the question, a condition is given in the question, that is, these two rods maintain, these two rods maintain a constant length difference at all temperatures. These two rods maintain constant length difference at all temperatures. Means what? The constant length difference x is maintained. It is given. The length difference LA minus LB, this length difference is x. That is given in the question. And this length difference is maintained constantly. Then find the original lengths of two rods. Find the original lengths of the two rods. Find the original lengths of the two rods. This is the question. Now the point is here, what is the given condition? How do we understand? So let us see. Say to this system of two rods, commonly we have provided some heat energy and their temperature rises. So now when the temperature of this two rod system raised, the observation is, the condition given is, they both maintain constant length difference, or difference of lengths remains the same at all temperatures. That is the given condition. Means what? For example, first one length, let it be some 10 centimeters. Second object, second rod length, let it be say some 9.8 centimeters. For example, just to for your understanding. And the difference is, say some 0.2 centimeters is the difference. I heat the two rods further, some more heat energy I will provide, further it is heated. Again, if I observe the length difference is again 0.2, like after giving some more heat, after providing some more heat energy, further they will expand, and suppose that let it be the final, the next length, let it be say some 10.2, and let it be 10 centimeters. Then again here length difference between A and B, again here it is 0.2. This is the condition. For example, means constantly the difference in length remains the same. So now what you have to find out here is find the original length of the rod. Means L1, L2 you have to find out. L1 and L2 you have to find out. So Jahnavi, Lahari, you understood the condition, given condition?
Yes, sir.
What is given? Yeah.
Yes.
What is given, if you understand, then we can proceed further. So the question, I hope you have the clarity of the question, what is given and what is asked. Now let us find out the L1 and L2. So now, here, alpha, we know that delta L by L delta T, this is the formula for alpha, means the linear expansion relation is this one. So two rods are here, two rods, two alpha values, alpha 1, alpha 2, two lengths L1, L2, delta L same, delta T same, all of you, I hope you are able to understand here, delta L same, the difference in length same, x only throughout, delta T, rise in temperature also same for two rods, but what is changing, what is the difference? The changing thing is alphas are not same, so alpha varies. Lengths of the two rods are not same, so alpha and L both varies. So what I can write? Alpha proportional to 1 by L I can write. And delta L is same, the change in length, the difference in length remains same at all temperatures. And this delta T is same for rod 1 and rod 2. Now what you can write here? Alpha 1 by alpha 2 is equals to L2 by L1 you can write. Tell me up to here, is it clear or not? I have arrived to this conclusion, and further we'll proceed. Tell me. If you have any doubt, you can ask in this. Clear?
Clear, sir.
Okay. Jahnavi? Okay, na? Okay. Okay. So, this is the relation between these two alphas and these two lengths, but this L1, L2 not given, we have to find out. Alpha 1, alpha 2 it's provided, so I am just relating their lengths with alphas as per the given condition. Now how I am going to write is this first length L1 minus second length L2, L1 minus L2 is equal to x given, and this I will take up, this one I will take, L2 by L1 equals to alpha 1 by alpha 2. So L2 by L1, how I am writing, see, from this L1 I am writing it as x plus L2, is it okay?
Yes.
Okay, na? Both of you.
Okay, sir.
So L1 I am writing it as x plus L2 equals to alpha 1 by alpha 2. So now if I cross multiply L2 alpha 2, this one and this one like this, L2 alpha 2 equals to this one, if I cross multiply, XL1 plus L2 alpha 1. Next, L2 I'll take common, L2, this is alpha 2 and this is alpha 1, so alpha 2 minus alpha 1 is equals to X alpha 1. Finally, L2 is equals to X alpha 1 by alpha 2 minus alpha 1. So this is the step by step process. Just go through this and tell me if you have any doubt. Anywhere at any step, if you need any clarification, you can ask. I found the second length, x alpha 1 by alpha 2 minus alpha 1. Okay, Lahari?
Okay, sir.
Okay, ma. So once if you know L2, then L1 you can easily find out. See this. So L1 minus L2 is x. So this L2 value, if you substitute here and add x, L1 also you can find out. So this, if you substitute here, L1 also you can find out. Okay. Yeah, Jahanavi, what happened?
Network connection is also.
Okay. So, is this clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So, in the next session, we'll discuss some more number of questions and some more number of concepts. We'll interact. So, we'll conclude here. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, ma.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, ma.